Hello everyone, so we are going to start the part 8 of colloidal dispersion. So in this particular unit we are going to deal with different mechanism by using which we can increase the stability of the colloids. Moreover, the different factors which affect the stability of the colloid. The thing is that the stability of the colloid is a very important aspect from the pharmaceutical point of view, as because most of the drugs they are supplied in the form of colloids. So if the stability of the colloid they remain for a long while, it always ensure a productive way of therapeutic, right? Means for a long time you can use that particular product. So let's start the topic, that is the stability. So stability of the colloid. So here you see we have a big chart in front of us. So this is a stable system. Suppose this is a stable system. Now this system upon storage for a time, say suppose 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, upon storing for a time, this system may either get flocculated. It may directly get flocculated, means the colloidal particles will come closer to each other. Or sometimes what may happen, after a long time it may get sedimented, means it will fall off. It will fall off, it will not remain further suspended in the dispersion medium, means it will fall off. After flocculation, then finally it can lead coagulation. It can lead coagulation, means agglomeration of the colloidal particle. Similarly, here also, in this process also, if it directly flocculate, then after the flocculation, the next step it is the coagulation, right? So afterwards, what will happen? As the molecule they coagulate, they will finally settle down, and we find the phase separation, means the colloid phase they will settle down at the bottom, whereas the dispersion medium they will remain clear, means the colloids they will separate themselves from that of the dispersion medium. So this is all about the stability of the colloids. Now let's discuss the stability and its aspect. So we know that the stabilization serves to prevent the colloids from aggregation, right? If we stabilize the colloids will not aggregate, and finally they will remain stable for a long while, right? So the presence, you see, the presence and the magnitude or absence of a charge, presence of a charge or absence of a charge on a colloidal particle, it's a very important factor in terms of stability. Presence of charge on the colloidal particle or absence of charge on the colloidal particle. Moreover, the magnitude, how much or what is the quantity, it all determines the stability of the colloids. So the two mechanism for colloidal or colloid stabilizations are, number one, steric stabilization. What do you mean by steric stabilization? So basically in the steric stabilization, what we used to do, we surround each colloidal particle with a protective solvent sheet, just similar to that of the lyophilic colloids. Means the colloidal particles will be surrounded, the colloidal particles will be surrounded by a sheath of the solvent, and this sheet will prevent the adherence, it prevents the adherence or coagulation due to the Brownian motion. As Brownian motion it is taking place, the molecule will have random movement, right? But the presence of the sheet over the particles, colloidal particles, it will hinder or it will stop the adherence of the particle to one another. That is the first mechanism. Then second mechanism, it is the electrostatic stabilization. Means what? We have to induce a charge, that is providing the particles with electric charge. Means the colloidal particle, if it is not having any type of charge over its surface, there we are going to provide a superficial charge. Clear? So now let's take the example with the lyophobic solution, or you can say colloids. So see, the lyophobic, they are generally unstable, right? Moreover, the particle in the lyophobic colloids or solution can be stabilized only by the presence of electrical charge on the surfaces, as because the lyophobic solutions or colloids, they don't have a greater tendency toward the dispersion medium as discussed earlier. Means the lyophobic colloids, they are generally dispersion, they generally hate the dispersion medium, thus they don't have a protective sheet of the dispersion medium over their surfaces. Thus the lyophobic colloids, they can be stabilized only by the presence of electrical charge on the surfaces through addition of small amount of the electrolytes. So if we add small amount of the electrolyte, this electrolyte will remain over the surface of the colloids, and finally they are going to get stable. So the like charges produces, if we add suppose some electrolyte, suppose we have added NaCl, so what will happen if all the colloids, they will absorb the sodium, the NaCl after means if we supply the NaCl, this NaCl will get dissociated into NaNCl, right? So this sodium or the chlorine, they can be means they can be absorbed over the surface of the colloid, and this lead to what? This lead to what? If all the colloids absorb a same type of ions, either you positive or negative, then like charges repel each other. Yes. So it will prevent the process of coagulation and thus subsequently settling down. But you see, addition of the electrolytes beyond the limit or maximum limit, what will happen? If we add more amount of the electrolytes, then you see accumulation of the opposite ions. Accumulation of the opposite ion will take place. Moreover, it will decrease the zeta potential, which led to the coagulation and led finally precipitation of the colloids. So the electrolyte has to be used in a limited amount. So this is a concept. You see, the colloidal stability requires the repulsion forces. So this is electrostatically stabilized. You see, these are the colloids, they have attained these charges over the surfaces, and these are the positive charges. So now these molecules, similarly other molecule will be there, which will have the same what? Negative charge. They will repel each other, but these positive charge will remain in the dispersion medium. But these positive charge, these are just in the form of molecular ions, so they don't have any role in the coagulation. Similarly, if you see, the lyophobic colloid can be stabilized by lyophilic colloid. Suppose there is a lyophobic colloid, if we want to stabilize that, suppose we want to stabilize a lyophobic colloid, we can sometimes add lyophilic colloid to that. This lyophilic colloid molecule may act as a polymer. See, you see, they may act as a polymer, and what may happen? This polymer may have charges, right? And they will finally helps in the process of repulsion. Now, coagulation. You see, coagulation also results from mixing of oppositely charged colloids. We know that if a colloid, it is attaining a positive charge, and similar colloid in the same system meeting attaining a negative charge, these two colloids can then definitely come close to one another, and then they are going to finally get settled, or the first they will get flocculated, then coagulated, then they are going to get settled, right? So case B, that is the lyophilic solution and association colloids. What actually happens in the stability? You see, the lyophilic, we know that they are stable because they have a sheet of the dispersion medium over the surfaces. Moreover, they generally present as a true solution, right? Now addition of moderate amount of the electrolyte in the lyophilic or association colloids, it don't causes any problem, as we have already discussed regarding all these things, right? But if we add more, then definitely there is a problem. So there is a concept here, that is the salting out. Now what do you mean by salting out? Simply, salting out means agglomeration or precipitation of the lyophilic colloids. Suppose there is a lyophilic colloid in a system, there is a lyophilic colloid in a, suppose there is a beaker, and in the beaker we have a lyophilic colloid. Now if we add some electrolytes, and if after adding this electrolyte, these lyophilic colloids, they get separated from the dispersion medium, means we generally get phase separation, means the colloids will separate themselves, they are going to get settled in the bottom, and the dispersion medium, they will remain in the top. If such conditions occurs, then this is known as the salting out. So salting out can be generally done by using some ions. So this can be obtained generally by addition of large amount of the electrolyte. So what are the electrolytes that you can use? Basically, you see anions. Anions can be used for salting out the colloids. So the anions have different power. So highest power of salting out, it is shown by citrate ions, citrate. The next it is shown by tartrate. The next it is shown by sulfate. The next acetate, chloride, nitrate, bromide, and iodide. Done. So the precipitate or the precipitation power, it is directly related to the hydration of the ion. Hydration means number of the OH group or number of water molecule carried by the or attached to the ion. So more the number of the hydroxyl group attached by the ion, or more the amount of the water molecule attached by the ion, more it will have the precipitating power. Clear? And its ability to separate the water molecules from the colloidal particles. Done. So next way, how we can salt it out? Next way, addition of less polar solvent. If we want to salt out a particular solution of colloids, we can use some less polar solvent like alcohol, acetone. Then, so you see, the addition of less polar solvent, what actually it will do? Addition of less polar solvent, it will render the solvent mixture unfavorable for colloids. And thus, what will happen? The solubility will come down and immediately separating of the colloid as well as the dispersion medium, which takes place, or dispersed phase or the dispersion medium, it takes place. There is a concept that is known as the co-servation. What is co-servation? It is nothing but it is the process of mixing negatively charged colloids and positively charged colloids. If a system have both negatively charged and positively charged colloids, then definitely as this they have opposite charges, they are going to get together, and this will lead to the what? First of all, they will get flocculated, then they will get coagulated, then they are going to get settled down, right? So this is known as, this process, it is known as co-servation. Clear? So there is one more term that is known as sensitization. So what is sensitization? It is a very simple concept. You see, addition of small amount of the hydrophilic or hydrophobic colloid. I repeat, addition of small amount of the hydrophilic or hydrophobic colloid to a hydrophobic colloid of opposite charges tend to sensitize, or sensitize means coagulate the particle. I repeat, you suppose we have a simple glass where we have some hydrophobic colloids, some metal ions, right? Now if we add small amount of the hydrophilic colloids with opposite charge, means this, suppose these colloids, we have a glass of water, there we have some metal ions which have a positive charge. Now if we add some lyophilic colloids to that system which have a negative charge, or some hydrophobic or lyophobic colloids to that system which have some opposite charge, just don't get confused. The basic concept is that the charge should be opposite. If we add lyophilic or hydrophilic or hydrophobic, whatever colloid, to that hydrophobic colloid system, in a glass we have a hydrophobic colloid system. If we add either a hydrophilic or a hydrophobic colloid system with opposite charge, it leads to the coagulation. This process, it is known as sensitization. So how it takes place, basically you see, so polymer flocculants, the polymer flocculants can bridge individually colloid particles by electrostatic interaction, that is attractive force of electrostatic interaction. Now if we are going to add a hydrophilic colloids or hydrophobic colloids or opposite charge, if that have a polymer or that can form a polymer like interaction, that is a polymer flocculants, it can bridge what it can go, these are the polymer flocculants, they can bridge the colloidal particle with one another with generally attractive forces of interaction. Done. So for example, if negatively charged colloidal silica particles, there we have a negatively charged colloidal silica particles, it can be easily flocculated by adding positively charged polymer. Here if we add some polymer, the polymer generally forms what? Lyophilic, right? I have already defined hydrophilic. So polymer solution, they generally form lyophilic. If we have a positively charged lyophilic polymer or negatively charged lyophilic polymer, and it can be used to coagulate a hydrophobic colloid of its opposite charge. Clear? So the next thing, it is the protection. So what do you mean by protection? Everybody have a protection. So this colloidal particle can be protected, right? How you are going to protect? By addition of large amount of the hydrophilic colloid. So why we use the hydrophilic colloid? The term, it is very simple. The hydrophilic colloid, they generally used to form a sheath. They generally used to form a sheath, S-H-E-A-T-H. They are going to form a sheath over the surface of the colloid, which helps in the stabilization actually. So the addition of small amount, or you can say addition of large amount of hydrophilic colloids, protective colloids, to a hydrophobic colloid tend to stabilize the system. So if there is a hydrophobic colloid, then system suppose made up of metal ions or metal particles, so that can be stabilized by using a hydrophilic colloid. This hydrophilic colloid will form a coating over the hydrophobic colloid. So this is the example. So this is, suppose this is a metal particle of colloidal range, and these are suppose the adsorbed polymer, right, of the lyophilic or hydrophilic colloid. So this may be due to the simple, the hydrophile, this hydrophile, they will absorb or they will form a monolayer on the hydrophobic particles. This hydrophilic particle, they will form a monolayer, and this monolayer finally led to what? It finally led to repulsion. Other particle will have the same polymer monolayer over their surfaces. Finally, it will form or it will cause repulsion. So thank you everyone for your patience hearing. If you like the video, just press the like icon. You can share this video, as well as you can subscribe to my channel. Thank you once again.